Next speaker, and we've got a blend of mature and experienced with young and lesser experience, is Sean McCulloch. Sean, a young man, works with City Building, and he is a quantity surveyor. And that is the guy who is responsible for making sure that contractors get paid, and on occasions, subcontractors get paid as well by the main contractor. But he works for a main contractor, so his job is to make sure the money's flowing in, and I suppose occasionally paying out to subcontractors. So Sean, could I ask you to come up, please? Thank you.
Hello, my name is Sean McCulloch, and this is my story so far. I grew up in Easterhouse, the Big Egg as some of us called it. Being from the east end of Glasgow and leaving school with no standard grades, I could never have imagined that 8 years later I would be standing here. Me of all people, I would be training to be a quantity surveyor and going to uni with all the clever clogs. I left school in 2007 when I was 14, and I gained a place in John Muir College doing construction full time. The school didn't throw me out because I was bad, it was because of my good attendance, which my mum kinda had something to do with, and being a teacher's pet, it helped me get recognised in school and gain a place in college. When I was at school, my strongest subject was techie. I really enjoyed making all the craft projects in class. And then when I left school and went to John Muir College, I attended it for 2 years. And in those 2 years, I'd done many different trades, but my favourite one I enjoyed most was joinery. At that age, making doors and windows and building partition walls, it felt really good to be able to go home and show your mum and your dad what you could do and what you could build all by yourself. After I finished college, I applied for an apprenticeship in City Building, and I was very happy when they phoned me back to say I was successful in getting an apprenticeship. Because I'd just done joinery for 2 years, I was kind of quick at picking up all the different tricks of the trade, and in my first year I got nominated for Commonwealth Apprentice of the Year. But sadly, I didn't win it, although I think I made up for it because I ended up winning it my second, third and fourth year. During my apprenticeship, I was lucky enough to get put in advanced craft at South Lanarkshire College, which is very nerve-wracking talking in front of my lecturers again. It's a more higher level of joinery, and it's more in-depth and technical stuff that you do. I also got excellent work experience in working in many different sites across Glasgow. I worked on Notre Dame in the West End, which is a old school which City Building took and done a beautiful refurbishment on it. And now when I drive by these buildings, I think to myself, I built that. In the last year of my apprenticeship, I got put forward to compete in a competition called Skills Build. It's the largest multi-trade competition in the world, and I competed against all colleges from all over Scotland, and I managed to achieve first place in this competition, which I was very proud of. City Building is a huge company which is continually growing and has loads of opportunities for me to develop. So when it was time to come to the end of my apprenticeship, I started to think about my future. What could I do if I could to possibly educate myself in construction more? I always wanted to progress up that ladder and try and go as far as I can. I spoke to some managers in City Building because I was never sure about what I wanted to do, and they kind of got me interested in doing my HNC in construction management. After starting my HNC, I then went on and done my final trades test, and I thankfully passed that and became a fully qualified joiner with City Building. 3 months later, a position came up for a trainee quantity surveyor, which I'm doing now and I've been doing for the past year. And when I applied for it, I was thankful that I got the job. City Building have put me through university to do my degree in quantity surveying at Cali Uni, which I'll be going to start at the end of October. Going from working with the tools for almost 5 years, it's kind of different swapping the hammer for a pen and paper, and it's hard to adjust to, and it's good to see what it's like running it from the other side, being involved in the management. But once you lay back and put your feet on the desk, it's actually not that bad. So to think, me as a 14-year-old boy, for the Big Egg, no sure what I wanted to do, just knew I liked making stuff in techie, enjoyed football, no sure what I wanted to do. To now, the knowledge that I've gained and the opportunities that lie ahead, it's overwhelming. It really has been a huge learning curve, and City Building have been a great support throughout. I would like to show the same support and possibly mentor younger apprentices in the future. My story shows that a career in construction is well educated and is worthwhile. A career in medicine, they fix bones, I fix buildings. But you have to want the career, as I believe the way to gaining success is believing you can succeed. Thank you.